Does it appear that he's left-handed or right-handed?
Blood, weapons, and three dead bodies. In this case, the bodies are dummies, designed to see how smart these UC Davis students are. It's a hands-on exercise that's part of a crime scene investigation class.
It's realistic as we can possibly make it without having a real body.
The basic scenario is that a jogger going by heard a gunshot and called the police.
In the scenario, the police called the homicide team. These 15 students are responding.
Seven is the unique one.
They're assigned to teams of five, each team tackling one room and one victim, looking for evidence.
That can be like footprints, dusty footprints, for example, inside the house, or bloody footprints.
They have an entire day to process, document, photograph, and record evidence. Their goal, like real homicide investigators, is to figure out how this crime unfolded.
The shows on TV make things seem very quick. You know, we have been here since 10 o'clock this morning, going on about 2:30, and we haven't even touched our body yet.
This is amazing. I've never actually worked any, you know, actual crime scenes, but just getting any sort of hands-on taste like this is great.
It's a pillowcase.
Think the class is unique? Well, so are the careers that benefit from it.
Because there looks like there could be a shoe print on there.
DNA analyst, law enforcement, and in Alex Deadman's case, forensic entomology?
The most common way that it's shown in homicide is determining time of death based on insect activities.
Like the others, Alex is looking for footprints and blood splatters.
Pattern 3A, is that evidence number 13?
Evidence even a forensic entomologist could use, particularly when the victims aren't warm-blooded.
And since, well, they're dummies, we don't have a lot of that here, so there's kind of a lack of insects.
No insects, but plenty of opportunities to learn from a real-life criminalist how to find answers when the victims aren't alive.
Every scene I've ever done, you know, I've always thought about it afterwards, and there's always things I think I could do better next time, even after 42 years.
Kristen Samos for UC Davis.